Blueberries, a true North American superfruit. Tough, hardy, perennial bushes that when treated right, will reward you with surprisingly large harvests. It's that time of year when your blueberry bushes are getting ready to bud out if they haven't already. A sure sign that spring is finally on its way. And if you don't have any blueberry plants yet, don't worry. Pretty soon they're going to be available to buy everywhere. Today, I've got a couple of three-year-old blueberry plants in need of some attention. I had originally planned to put these guys straight into the ground, but I thought today would also be a great time to show you how I make my blueberry soil. So instead, let's repot these guys into some larger containers and learn a little bit about blueberry growing along the way. Blueberry plants in North America come in two different varieties, highbush and lowbush. The vast majority of the plants we grow and that are grown commercially are highbush. The lowbush types from the eastern part of the continent are a bit of a crazy bunch. They prefer swampy woodlands and they're mostly harvested wild or managed in place rather than a truly cultivated crop. So for us, we'll be talking mostly about the highbush blueberry requirements, and that's what you're likely going to be growing anyway. Like we said, blueberries are a perennial. They're a real cold hardy plant. The winter dormancy stimulates the fruit and bud formation every year in a process known as vernalization. Speaking of those flowers, blueberries can self-pollinate, but they're very, very poor at it. You'll get much bigger and much more reliable harvests if you can grow more than one blueberry within 10 feet of each other. That's important because you want the bees and the other pollinators to be able to carry the pollen around from each plant, from each flower, in a single visit. The higher pollination count is obviously going to result in higher berry counts, so this is a big one, guys. That's great for spacing, but what about location? Well, blueberries are a sun-loving plant. Really? As much direct sunlight as you can give them, but for sure a minimum of 6 to 8 hours a day. Now, they're not massively fond of high winds or exposure, so a little protection is appreciated. Blueberries also need their share of moisture, especially if you want them to produce those plump berries. But while the lowbush types can tolerate soggy, wet conditions, the highbush kinds cannot. Standing water is a no-no. So, make sure the area that you dig your blueberry plants into drains free of excess water. Or, if you're growing in pots or containers, make sure there's adequate drainage holes. For how big they grow, blueberry plants are very shallow rooted. I've seen more than one blueberry plant die in the summer heat, so you gotta be careful. A nice thick mulch layer is extremely beneficial for all plants, but especially blueberries. Now for the big daddy of blueberry requirements, parameters, whatever you want to call it. That's right, soil. Now, soil is pretty important for all plants, but blueberries have some unique requirements. Most of our crops are going to thrive in a neutral soil, which would be about a pH of 7. Blueberries, on the other hand, well, they're acid lovers. To really thrive and grow properly, their pH needs to be way down to about 4.5 to 5.5. This is likely a way lower pH than any of the soils in our garden, and much more acidic than any of the soils we'd ever buy at the store. Because of this, when growing blueberries, we're likely going to need to amend. Fertilizer designed to lower the pH can be helpful, no doubt, but it's also very short-lived. For a longer-lasting approach, there are some amendments that we can use, and we're going to touch on them in just a second when it's time to plant. One last thing before we get there, though. If you've ever grown blueberries before, you may have had issues with the leaves yellowing or becoming pale. 9 times out of 10, this is an iron deficiency. But the irony of it all is that your soil likely isn't deficient in iron. Instead, it's probably once again that pH thing rearing its ugly head. Alkaline or even sometimes neutral pH soils tend to lock up iron and other essential elements away from blueberry roots. So, this acid-loving trait isn't just a passing fancy. With blueberries, it's quite real. All right, let's get to some planting. Now, blueberry plants can live for up to 25 years or more, and they get quite large. Unless your plant is just a young one and you need a temporary home, you're going to want to go with a container size of 10 gallons, minimum. We're going to keep growing in containers today, but if you're planting your blueberries straight into the ground, keep watching, because all the same rules apply. So, I've got my pot all picked out. Let's talk that most important variable, soil. Your success at growing healthy blueberry plants is all going to start below ground. It's the soil and the qualities that it possesses that's going to dictate how this goes. Highbush blueberries need moisture, but not at the expense of air. This means that the best soil for them is one that drains freely, but can also hold water. And as we all know, the best holder of water is organic matter. Now, specific blueberry soils do exist, but they're not always available, and they're definitely pricey. Instead, you can buy a simple potting or container mix and adjust it slightly. Today, we're going to do just that, as well as make a batch from scratch. The recipe couldn't be simpler. Take 3 parts potting soil and mix it with 1 part fine bark chips. Add in a few cups of perlite, and that's it. That's all you need for an amazing blueberry container mix. Now, if you're starting from scratch like I like to do, it's just as easy. You'll want to take 50% coconut fiber, or peat if you have to, 50% compost, and mix that up. Once again, take 3 parts of that, 1 part of the fine bark chips, and then add in your perlite. That's it. That's all a blueberry mix needs to be. But what about that pH? I tested these 2 soils earlier, and they're both much too high for blueberries. So what can we do? Well, this is where our amendments come in. There's many different products out there that you can use, but the best is elemental sulfur. This stuff is going to keep the pH lower for longer in a much stabler, much safer way. I just incorporate it right into that blueberry mix. That's it. Pretty easy stuff. Now, it is slow release, and if you've got an extremely high pH soil, well, you might going to want to use a fertilizing solution designed to drop the pH, at least to get the plant started. And speaking of getting started, it's time to plant. First, I'm just going to pop these guys out of their old pots and see what we're dealing with. Now, if you're buying yours at the store dormant and bare rooted, this is the stage where you're at. We're just catching up to you. As you can see, a fairly minimal fibrous root system, especially for the size of the plant that it supports. I'll shake off the majority of the old soil so we can start fresh. Not too rough though, no need to stress out the plant unnecessarily. At this point too, try to remove any of the weeds that may have taken over the pot. For some reason, grasses just love to live with blueberries. I don't know why. Okay, for potting, or in this case repotting, I'm going to put a good amount of soil in to start with. This will help to spread out those fibrous roots horizontally, which tend to live at the surface anyway. Now comes the fun part. Just place the plant inside and backfill with your blueberry mix. Super easy, but highly rewarding stuff. We do need to water, but hold off. We're going to mulch first. It'll help keep the soil in place when we do water, and it's going to keep the moisture locked in. It's not hyperbole when I say that a mulch just sets your blueberries up right. Okay, time to water. A good thorough soaking is best. Take your time and really get the whole profile moist. With that elemental sulfur in place, our pH should begin to drop, but it doesn't happen right away, like we said before. So, I'm going to fertilize with a solution that's designed to push the pH downwards. One good application should tide us over. I'll go ahead and find a nice sunny but protected spot for these guys, and we're done for the day. Alright, the pH and the bark chip thing aside, pretty straightforward stuff. Not much different from all of our other potted plants. Still, let's recap those main points to make sure that we don't miss anything. Blueberries are a hardy cold climate perennial that uses winter dormancy to set itself up for success. All of their fruiting and vegetative buds develop during this time, and in the late winter, early spring is when we start thinking about planting them. Whether in the ground or in a large container, blueberries need an organic-dominated soil mix that drains well and holds on to a low pH. No question, these guys are acid-loving plants, and in alkaline or even neutral-type soils, well, they can start to suffer. We can use fertilizers to drop the pH in the short term, but your best bet is a soil additive or amendment, such as elemental sulfur. With the right soil all set, blueberries are going to enjoy a location that gets full sun. And if looked after, even just moderately, could easily live and produce for you for two decades or more. Blueberries, once set up right, are going to reward you with berry goodness year after year, with very little maintenance. Keep the pH low, fat drainage high, and give them plenty of light. Solve those three things, and you'll be blueberry masters in no time. Hey, happy growing, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Hey, thanks so much for watching, guys. I appreciate the support more than you know. And if you're getting value from these videos, please like and share them to spread the word and help your fellow gardener to grow better.